midfielders in Major League Soccer, but what should be the Timbers' fortress is at risk of becoming something of a house of horrors. And by the way, real danger that all of them will miss out on the postseason. Here to play on those frailties are perhaps the league's most improved team. If Minnesota win today, they will make the playoffs for the first time in their history. Plenty to chew on then in the Heineken pre-game showcase. The Western Conference is very, very tight. Over in the East, six of the seven playoff places are decided. Here in the West, only one, Taylor.
It's unreal, John, when you look at it. A week ago today, you and I were standing right here. LA Galaxy were playing for their lives against Sporting Kansas City. Still a lot to play for in the Western Conference.
Certainly is. Well, Taylor Twellman alongside me. Confirmation that autumn is on the way. He's been to the charity shop and he's got a new sweater.
I pulled it out of his closet, don't worry about it. 44 long.
So here we are at Portland again, second week running. We didn't necessarily think we would be here at one stage because it seemed like their qualification for the playoffs would be a foregone conclusion. It isn't.
Absolutely, John. I think one of the biggest storylines of 2019 was the opening of Providence Park and all the renovations they did, but also what did it mean to the peculiarness of Major League Soccer's schedule? 10 straight home games for the Portland Timbers. And that run started when you and I were in Minnesota and they lost on the road to Minnesota United both in the regular season and in the Open Cup. Since then, they've lost four of the last six games here at home. They've been anemic, they've been predictable, and their backs are against the wall, and it's their doing, no one else. Big surprise for me so far that Portland's in this spot.
Yeah, and surprises in the lineup. Five changes today, and no Diego over there.
Yeah, that's a big surprise. Mabiala comes into the lineup. He's missed the last six games. Valentin will play left back. He won't go forward a ton. Flores will come in the middle with Diego Chara, but no Diego Valeri. Tired legs, whatever the reason may be, Blanco will play his position. But the key for the Portland Timbers and their anemic attack is the three underneath Fernandez. They've got to be more unpredictable, more dangerous going forward, especially after what you and I saw last week against DC United.
Now, as for Minnesota, so much more straightforward for them. You get the feeling they're not playing with any particular pressure. They're well set in fourth place in the West. They just want to nail down a home playoff. A win today gets them in the playoffs for the first time in their history. And in their lineup, as the players take to the pitch here at Providence Park, just the one change with Chase Gasper returning at left back after suspension.
Well, pretty consistent from Adrian Heath from Minnesota United. Only three losses in the last 14 games. Gasper comes in the lineup. I love Ike Parr and Boxel, that partnership. One of them can't get isolated 1v1 against Fernandez going forward. Alonzo Gregouche. Gregouche has been underrated in the best 11 conversation. He won't make it, but he should be in that conversation. But this is all about Darwin Quintero, because Minnesota United will go as far as they can in the playoffs if Quintero of last week, that scored two goals against Real Salt Lake, shows up, and Kevin Molino, Lude, and Mason Toye up front supply that. But if Darwin Quintero is on his best game, watch out for Adrian Heath and Minnesota United in the playoffs.
All set then for a third meeting of the season between the Timbers and the Loons. History beckons for Minnesota, but for Portland it's a day when home comforts need to be fully embraced. Another helping of playoff peril coming right up. You've been watching the Heineken pre-game showcase.